Come on then, you middle of the noise, let's see what you're about. Yeah, make all that noise and then we're all about it.
Races caused here, isn't it? They spent loads of fucking noise, I think they're about 130 in the amount of
noise. For all that is caused, then.
Thank you. This one was particularly made. It was built in 1928. It's a five car race. And then it was raced as a solo in 1930. On the start line, I can't see the number. So I apologise at this point, I can see no information. But whatever it is, it's obviously a classic racing car of years gone by. And hopefully for the next run, I will find out what it is. Number 18, which is a Bentley 1920 with some very distinguished guests. We've got George Dunning, who is the leader of the council. We've got Tom Blenkinsop in the seat. We'll just take five now while the first competitors that went up come down, because you can only hold so many at any one time at the top. There isn't that much room. Ash TT replica, built in 1935. Listen to the engine as it winds up and Peter gives it a little bit of go to get to the corner. Next up is number 26, who is Gerald Driver in his 1934 Austin 7 Nippy. It was classed as a two-seat open-top sports car of its era of 1934. It's known as the Type 65. Looks to be in very nice condition and a lovely, genuine renovation to keep it as original as possible. '35 is Grant Sellers in his 1931 Morgan Sports, and as for obviously is a three-wheeler. And the Morgans are still made today if you you follow motoring sport at all, motoring at all. If you look, it's got an engine on the outside in the front, and that is a V-twin Jap with 1000cc. And for those of you who are a little more technically minded, if you look, both cylinders and cylinder heads are of 500cc each, and they were from the famous Jap Speedway bike that was used by riders all the way from the 20s right through till the early 1970s. And they're just the same as the ones on the Speedway bike, built onto a common crank. Up is number 38, which is Mr. George Laycock from Moulton in his Grenfell Special of 1948 era. It's a two-seater with a Ford V8 built for hill climbs and sprints, so this is its forte. Looks to be a very original motor car from the year that it was built, 1948. 1934 Alvis Marendal Special. Next up is a 1936 Morris 12-4, and as you can see, this is a highly modified vehicle of Terry Morgan from Nunthorpe in Middlesbrough. Next up is Chris Hunwick of Gisborough in his Vauxhall 10. Doesn't look very much like a Vauxhall to me. Obviously been highly modified. Passing by. Now we could return to two wheels, and the first one to come to the line will be Harry Knight of Herwith near Darlington on quite an interesting motorcycle, even to me. This is a Douglas Aero 600cc, 1935 vintage. It was found in a box of bits and has been restored completely. And it sounds like the old Douglas is having some starting difficulties. Right, well, while Harry gets that sorted out, we're moving on to number 49. On a 1939 OK Supreme 350 with a Jap engine. Now, as you remember a few minutes ago, I was telling you about Grant Sellers with his Jap engine V-twin, and if you look at the cylinder and head of that one that's just gone up, it just looked like one of the cylinders off the V-twin. Next up is number 41, which is Chris Bates on his 1936 North Model 18. One of many of the classic motorcycles of the British design. Number 53 is quite a little bit special. It's a 1936 PSA Empire Star. And again, like we said with the Douglas, it was found in large lumps in the mid-50s. It's been rebuilt by its current owner, and he actually rode it here today, complete with sidecar. We've now got Harry's got his Douglas going, and he's on the line to take his vehicle up. Have a look at this one, it's an unusual machine. There are not many of these around. You see, quite a rare motorcycle. Quite a rare motorcycle. Harry's a local enthusiast for motor vehicles, especially two wheels, and he's got quite a selection of these, of different machines. This is the one he's brought with him today. most famous racing motorcycles of all time, to 7R AGS. It's 350cc and this is one of the earlier versions. Probably, just looking at it from where I am, it's around early 50s, maybe late 40s, early 50s. Number 44, which is Will Taylor on his Model 40 North. And Bill's doing the part. If you look, he's got classic period leathers with his classic period helmet on, and the machine is beautifully prepared. And listen to the exhaust note on this as he takes it away from the start. Next up is number 42, which is Peter Jackson. You've just seen Peter go up in his car, now you see him going up on his Velocette. And this is the Velocette equivalent of the AGS you've just seen go up. This is a KTT Velo, 350cc. And again, listen to the exhaust note, it's beautiful, if you like that sort of thing. Next up is number 52, which is Kay Suggett. No, sorry, beg your pardon, I've got that wrong. 52, it's Mac, that's right, it's Mac. He likes to be known as Mac. It's Mac on his 1937 BSA Empire Star. Near of 350cc, I believe. If my memory serves me right. Was a classic BSA of that era. Next up is number 50, I think, which is a 1947 Norton Inter. I think it's a 500 from where I'm sitting. They made them in 350 and 500, but he's nodded his head, so I guess that means it's a 500. This is one of the machines in when you were a young man, just after the war, that you wanted to aspire to own. Very exotic motorcycle in its day. Samurai. And that sounds rather exotic. Next up is number 51, John Foster, in a 1973 Hillman Hunter. I can reminisce about these because my father had one.
Snap.
Next up is Neil Pearson, number 94, again with a Norton frame, but look at the engine again, a different one again. These are hand-built engines made by a guy called... we go again. We started off again. Number three is Tom Norman on his 1921 P&M, which stands for Felon and Boer, or better known to us all as a Panther. And it's of 3.5 horsepower. Extremely advanced.